Buzzing this afternoon, a Los Angeles elementary school has removed its entire staff while the school district investigates lewd conduct by two teachers. The superintendent says 88 teachers and 40 support staff at Miramont Elementary are being replaced while they're interviewed by investigators. Another staff has been trained and will take over for the time being. One of the accused teachers is charged with committing lewd acts on 23 children. The other is accused of fondling two girls in his classroom. We're told parents are divided over the decision to remove the entire staff. They're concerned this will add to the children's trauma over the current scandal, but others say they support whatever needs to be done to help with the investigation and to protect their children. What's your take?
All right, Dave Sislak is here, your communication expert. Yeah. Here in the Valley, this is a huge story, especially on the West Coast. Right. An entire school staff removed.
Yeah, it's a horrible story. I mean, if you've read the details of that, it is just, it's devastating what happened there. You know, I think first things first, you have to protect the kids. If there is any suspicion at all that any teachers were involved in the cover-up of that, then they do need to be removed. They do need to be suspended. I can't imagine in a school of that size that every single teacher knew that something was going on and that everybody failed to act. But as the investigation unfolds, I think you really do have to make sure that the kids are safe. That's priority one.
And yeah. We should point out the teachers are being paid. They've right. just been moved to another location so that they can be interviewed and that they're not being disruptive of you know, the teaching process. Other teachers have been brought in. Sure.
And so, and the superintendent here, really, a lot of teachers praising the superintendent for saying, you know what, good for you. His mm-hmm. comments were, I can't take any more chances. I don't want anything else to pop up that I didn't know about and any more kids to be put in harm's way, because who knows how many more children are out there that could have been victims.
Yeah, and from a communication standpoint, I mean, first of all, it's obviously safety first for the kids. And then the second thing is you got to make sure that you're communicating with parents mm-hmm. and with the community. The last thing you want is to reenact the scandal that the church went through, you know, years ago, with all the cover-ups and all that. So I think it's smart for that superintendent to be saying, hey, I'm taking action right now. I'm stopping this thing. We're moving everybody out of here as this investigation unfolds.
Yeah, you can't do too much to make a child safe.
No.
One child, the whole school. I mean, you just can't.
No, I mean, you don't want to take that risk. And if that means removing everybody as they conduct interviews and let the police do their job, that is the smart thing to do.
And if all of those teachers are innocent, of course, they'll get their...
But a lot of parents arguing that point, you know, there are some great teachers at this school. Are we doing the right thing by kind of doing a brushstroke over everyone? And here's what you guys are saying on Facebook about that exact fact.
Joy Atore says, I think it is fair because it is highly unlikely that these two accused were the only ones that were involved. Someone's not talking, and it makes you wonder where your kids are safe.
Socorro Martinez, these teachers' futures are at stake. They need to get their facts right.
Sarah Leonard says, good God, what is wrong with people? I truly don't think it is a horrible idea. Someone had to know or be suspicious. If they want their job, they will talk.
Monique Menjarez says, take action against the two predators, not all the teachers. And that's the argument. A lot of people feel like there are some great educators at this school. Do we dump them all?
And I would ask Monique and others who say things like that, if you had a child that was at that school, would you want to take that risk? Mm-hmm. Is that something that you're comfortable with, sending your kid back there knowing that a teacher could be part of this thing?
Yeah, a lot of parents are keeping their kids home right now because of that.
I don't blame them.
Well, also